tren de las 6, 7 de la noche.
And we have another stop. We came to Ollantaytambo, which is Inca site. Just behind me here are the ruins, and we are gonna go and see them together in just a minute.
Señor, avanzamos, mostramos el boletito ahí.
Here it is, guys. This is just incredible. Of course, we have to go up all of these stairs.
Our beautiful view of Ollantaytambo district, beautiful from here, but from the top side is complete the view. Pero bueno, desde acá se ve muy bonito, imagínense desde la cima, la vista es completa, pueden sentarse, acomódense.
Es que de aquí te íbamos a avisar que de aquí nos
bajamos. Ya, ya, está bien,
ubicado a 2750 metros sobre el nivel del mar.
This district, Ollantaytambo, is over 2,750 meters above sea level.
This district, this is the lowest place in our tour.
Y Ollantaytambo conserva el trazo original de hace 500 años atrás. Calles angostas, estrechas como vía peatonal. Sobre estructura incástica hoy en día el pueblo de Ollantaytambo. Por eso Ollantaytambo es conocido como ciudad inca viviente. Karen entre Ollantaytambo Town, still conserving the original urban design from the Inca time with narrow street, narrow pathway. Well, Ollantaytambo we know currently as a living Inca village. Ollantaytambo. From here we can see those buildings on the Picuyuna mountain with open windows, entrance, access. Those are colcas. Colca means a storehouse where the product was safe inside. Las construcciones que vemos allá encima, señores, esas construcciones que vemos son colcas, graneros, depósitos de alimentos. Y está permitido llegar allá, a las colcas. Solamente hay que disponer de tiempo, tener una hora y media para poder llegar a las colcas. Terminamos walk up until colcas o warehouses. Where is the colca sector? There we have the old man face. Old man, el rostro de un hombre viejito. ¿Dónde te ves? Y por tanto, hoy en día nosotros, con los pobladores del lugar de acá de Urubamba, atribuyen que ese sería el rostro del Tunupa. Tunupa o Viracochán, el mensajero del dios de los incas. Well, according to legend, local legend, we have here that around 15th century, old man arrived here, giving all the goodness to all inhabitants. At the first time, it was agreed the inhabitant with this old man, but while the time passed, they appreciate all the knowledge that he had. But while the time passed, he has to continue the other countries. Currently, it takes the name of this old man. smart, ¿no? We were here for different aspects, astronomy, medicine, architecture, among others. The name of that is Tunupa or Wiracochan. Wiracochan refers as a messenger of the Incas gods. Well, by the legs of the mountain in Cuyuna, we have the winter solstice projection every June 21st by the left of the mountain. By the left of the mountain, winter solstice every June 21st. Well, over here, aquí observen, por el lado izquierdo de ese cerro Pincuyuna, los primeros rayos del sol impactan a la cima. Cada solsticio de invierno 21 de junio. Y el impacto llega de esta manera. Observen, miren. Sale por el lado izquierdo y la proyección llega de esta manera a la cima. So the projection reaches the top in the triangular shape. The which is the top area. Every June 21st, sending the message that we are passing to the dry season. When it's rainy season, along the join of the mountain, it's December 22, and the projection reaches the summit the same place. Cada diciembre 22 de diciembre, cada 22 de diciembre, solsticio de verano 22 de diciembre llega a la cima, los primeros impactos, al mismo lugar donde también la proyección se da del solsticio de invierno 21 de junio, la parte alta. Es por esto que en la cima se encuentra el templo del sol, la parte alta. Y la arquitectura que está cerca a la parte megalítica donde existen bloques de gran tamaño es muy perfecta. Y desde acá se ve la parte baja, intermedia, por eso le decían no hay necesidad de subir, pero si alguien quiere subir, normal subimos también. Well, on the top side we have megalithic architecture. Close to the megalithic architecture, where is the Sun Temple, the Inca architecture or structure is perfect. So perfectly refers Ollantaytambo, it was an astronomical area. Why important to study the constellation Milky Way for Incas? To know the proper time, start with the harvest month or the planting or the production time. No, with winter solstice, harvest months. Summer solstice start the production or the planting, no? Along the year to obtain products. Mainly the agriculture was the reason to study the constellation Milky Way. Estudiar las constelaciones Vía Láctea para los andinos y nuestros antepasados los incas había de ser muy importante por el tema de la agricultura. Para saber las fechas fijadas de siembra de cosecha, ¿no? Como es el caso del solsticio de invierno, indicando la fecha de cosecha. Solsticio de verano, meses o semanas propicias de inicio de siembra, ¿no? Por eso es importante la en este caso, la agricultura basada en la astrología.
Llegamos a
As you can see here, guys, this place is just amazing. What the Inca Empire was able to build up in these mountains. Gosh, I'm just very happy to be here. And this is why it's called the Sacred Valley, because there is a river flowing down here, and they were able to cultivate crops here. The river was providing water necessary for life, for growing food. Sacred Valley. Just look at these big blocks of stone.
Del cual se extrajo el material pétreo, todo el material pétreo que rodó al fondo del valle a través de un camino plano fue arrastrado. Aquí, amigos, Cristian, aquí estamos, por aquí, precioso. En un momento vamos a ver la evidencia de arrastre. Gonna see the moment, the evidence of the transportation system. From where the huge rock it was brought, the Black Mountain distance, Hachihata Quarry sector, from where it was brought. All the huge rock that was split out, rolled down into the valley. By plain area, it was pulled after the huge rock until here. Cantera Hachihata, de allá se extrajo el material que tenemos aquí alrededor. El material que tenemos es la riolita rosada, señores, que tiene 6 grados en escala de dureza. The scale of most, 6 degree in scale most, the pink riolite that we have here, huge megalithic rock. Hematite, which has 9 degree scale most, it was used to polish. We know the material which has more scale modes would help the other which have less scale modes. At the same sand water that was used as abrasive, utilizaron arena, agua como abrasivo para lograr el pulido. Pero se ayudaron con la jiguaya, que tiene 9 grados en escala de dureza. Sabemos que un material que tiene mayor dureza puede otra de menor dureza, como es la arbolita rosada, que tiene 6 grados en escala de dureza. Es ese material que tenemos. Estos bloques de gran tamaño que vemos, conocidos hoy en día como el templo de Tsuyu, porque la proyección del solsticio de invierno 21 de julio llega aquí, e igualmente solsticio de verano, every December 22, summer solstice, which here the projection. Winter solstice by the left of the mountain at the same year. By the from here we can see better the profile of the Inca. Toward left of the mountain, por el lado izquierdo de esa montaña se ve el perfil del Inca. Acá sí lo puedo mostrar, de la base no se puede ver. Lado izquierdo, sobre el perfil del Inca, solsticio de invierno, 21 de junio. Above the profile of the Inca face, where is over left of the mountain, the winter solstice projection, every June 21st. Por el lado izquierdo. ¿Lograron ver el perfil? ¿Alguien que no logró ver? Con confianza, díganlo, a ver. Sí, miren, la cima, una banderita. Primer descenso, la pendiente, pico. Algo que sobresale como pico. Pico, seguido a ello el perfil. You can see flat. Second, the winter solstice every June 21st, 21 de junio, solsticio de invierno por el, sobre el perfil del Inca, y solsticio de verano por la unión de esas dos montañas, que llega aquí, every December 22, between the joining of the mountain, the summer solstice, and here the projection ridge. That's why this area considers an astronomical area, but unconcluded. Many huge rock, as we see, partially Ollantaytambo, astrological area, este lugar astronómico, en el pasado siglo XV.
Right here on these two terraces, it's an example of oh, the wind is just so bad. So on these two terraces here, they planted potatoes just as an example for the tourists to see how these terraces used to be utilized. So, we just finished the tour visiting Ollantaytambo, amazing place, megalithic stones, artificial terraces built by the pre-Incas and Incas. You can definitely see some differences in one part of the site compared to the other one, which shows that one part was older than the other one. So Inca people came here and they built or rebuilt on top of what it was before. At least that is my personal opinion. And it's also an Inca site, and we're just gonna sit down, and it's very windy, yeah, and the temperature dropped a little bit, so that's why the hoodie.
well, the second level too is so windy. As we already feel in the other spots, Ollantaytambo, when we saw the violent storm, we must be prevent stay close to the wall if you walk up the second level. Otherwise, I suggest you need a cover on this first level. First, we are safe. Bueno, señores, nuestra seguridad lo primero ante todo. Entonces, lo otro puede ser de la esquina pasar al primer barrio. Acá este es el primer barrio Cantuxajay. Visajes enormes, señores. Aquí estamos a 3,450 metros. Luego de la explicación, vamos a tener espacio para conocer fotografías, vistas de este hermoso lugar. Y son tres barrios los que tenemos. Cantuxajay es este primer barrio. El segundo barrio es Cayacas. Esos dos barrios se pueden visitar. El tercer barrio está allá al fondo, es el barrio llamado Isaac. Al tercer barrio no podemos llegar porque el camino que conduce allá a ese tercer barrio fue afectado producto a la falla geológica. El camino fue quebrado, esto en el año 2010. Parte de este primer barrio también fue afectado. Y por tanto, los barrios permitidos a visitar, segundo barrio y primer barrio. All its neighborhood allow visit. First neighborhood Cantuxajay, second neighborhood Cayacasa as well, allowed visit, but the last neighborhood where is the distance, Isaka neighborhood, currently we couldn't visit, because the way which conduces to the last neighborhood, it was affected to the natural form. The sliding affects the way which conduces the last neighborhood, which refers only second part and this part allowed to visit. Well, now we are on 3,450 meters above sea level. Stay to the wall, please, close to the wall, thank you. Well, from here we can see the terraces, longest, widest, around the mountain as the same, but we have many terrace system. From the upper side until lower, it has a weather difference, 8-10 degrees Celsius, depending month and of the year. It has around 40 microcosystems, microenvironments. That's why the terrace system here in Pisac is known as an experimental laboratory of Incan agriculture. All the terrace system that we have here. Las terrazas, almenerías, plataformas incas que tenemos, señores, desde la parte alta hasta el fondo del valle, presenta diferencia de temperatura entre 8 a 10 grados centígrados. Alrededor de 40 microambientes, microclimas, por eso conocido las plataformas, terrazas, almenerías incas de Pisa como laboratorio de experimentación de agricultura inca del Valle Sagrado de los Incas. Y bien, la parte superior lograron tubérculos, intermedio, quinoa, quinopodium, maíz en el fondo del valle, y por eso en todo el Valle del Urubamba, Valle Sagrado de los Incas, tenemos a más de 128 variedades. El mejor grano que Cusco exporta para el mundo es el maíz blanco, que nosotros decimos en quechua parajay, o maíz inca imperial. On the upper side of the terrace system, it was necessary to obtain the tubers. Following, it was obtained the quinoa quinopodium, and then the core of maize. Thanks to that, Urubamba Valley has more than 128 varieties of core. One of them, the best one, where Cusco exports to the world, is the widest core that we call in Quechua Parajay or Inca Imperial Core, no? Which obtains with the families currently obtained from the Urubamba Valley or Wilcamayu Valley in this case. Well, the houses that we have here is pre-Inca, rustic style, which belong to Quilque Ayarmarca settlements. The evidence it was found in 1964 by Manuel Chavez Ballon, Cuscanian scholars, due to the ceramic pottery presence, which informed the Quilque Ayarmarca settlement lived around 801,000 after the Christ and over pre-Inca the Inca reuse this place. The evidence we have in the second neighborhood, Inca wall evidence, are the same, the shape of the buildings, semi-trapez with a shape. Their buildings, their access, the windows are the same, not 100% pre-Inca. When it's pre-Inca, 100% as we have to this along the south part of Cusco City as Piquillacta, Wari settlement, which occupies along the south part, which comes from 700 after the Christ. Their construction is different. It has quadrangular windows, rectangular access, as the same. Their enclosure is quadrangular or rectangular, not semitrapezoidal that we have here in the first neighborhood or the second one. Lugar, señores, es arquitectura mixta lo que tenemos, pre-inca e inca. La arquitectura rústica, piedra no labrada, sencilla con mortero barro, hizo de que muchos estudios vinieran a este lugar, y es así que en el año 1964 el estudioso queño Manuel Chávez Bayón encontró fragmentos de cerámica, y ello indica de que los pre-incas, como los quilques, ayarmarcas, vivieron aquí en el año 800, año 1000 después de Cristo. Entonces, esa arquitectura rústica que se tiene en el lugar perteneciente a los pre-incas, pero sobre esto los incas lo utilizaron, porque los incas se caracterizaron por presentar forma semitrapezoidal, en este caso sería una forma trapezoidal, como se tiende allá en el segundo barrio. Este primer barrio también presenta ellos. No es 100% pre-inca lo que se conserva a la fecha, porque lo pre-inca, señores, tenemos en el Valle Sur, como es Huari, la capital de los Huaris, Piquillacta, e incluso está en el boleto para que puedan visitar alguno. Inca, Libant, here, until 1572. El lugar fue ocupado hasta el año 1572 por los incas. A la llegada de los españoles todo cambió. La orden del quinto virrey del Perú, Francisco de Toledo, hizo que estas personas se recuperaran en el fondo del valle, al Valle Quitamayo. Y por tanto, la población colonial se asentó desde el año 1572. Y desde ese entonces,
and 1 month where?
1 month Peru, 1 month in Chile.
Oh, like that?
Yeah.
Nice.
How long are you traveling?
3 months in total. Nice. So, our guide was telling us that after we visit the site, we are just gonna go down in the city to visit a museum, the Museum of Silver or something like that, and I think that is gonna be our last stop for today. But hey, Pisac, thank you. This is Isaac. An Inca site, very interesting. I'm just happy to be here. Now we are just leaving the site and going down in the Isaac city. We are gonna visit a museum there, and that is all for today. I am gonna close this vlog here because I don't have that much battery left. I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog from today. Thank you so much for the support. Thank you so much for following. And yes, see you in the next vlog.